Now that you have a solid understanding of library structures, their hierarchy, and how you might want to set them up organizationally, I think what we want to do is start from scratch. Let's have the audience understand what it takes when you create a new library, what happens, where the media goes. I think that would be a very good place to start.
Yeah, and this is the beginning point, and this is the point at which you decide how the library gets set up and where the media is going to go. So let's dive in here.
All right. So let's create a new library. I'm going to go to the File menu, New Library. Dialog comes up, asks you to save and name your library. And you could store your library on any drive.
And in any location, doesn't have to be at the root. So you can choose exactly where you want to store it. And that decision, by the way, let's come back to where you might want to store it, because it has to do with whether or not you're going to put the media inside it.
Right.
Right. So where are you going to put yours for
now? Well, first I want to name it. I want to create a library that's all about California diving.
Okay.
So I'm going to type out California underwater. And I'm going to just save it right to my movies folder.
That's the default, right?
That's the default.
Comes up.
But if you have an external drive like I do here, just Ripple Media, you can store it on any external drive. As you can see, I already have some libraries pre-existing there.
Okay.
I'm just going to put it in the movies folder.
Great.
And also something that's new is if you tag things in the Finder, they get tagged when you bring them in.
Ah, so these are Finder tags where it says tags there.
Mm-hmm.
So the feature of in Mavericks where you can apply tags. In fact, you already have, you've created custom tags already for other reasons, and they're all available here.
They're all available.
So you can choose those, or you could create a new tag here and it would be imported as a keyword collection.
Right. I already have a tag called Underwater Video, but I can just tag it that way right,
okay.
Just right there because it's already there.
Yep.
Right. I'm going to click Save. Now, you'll notice that I have a new library up here called California Underwater. And something that's new to Final Cut 10.1.2 is that you have this new area that opens automatically when a new library is created.
So the inspector opened by itself. You didn't open it.
I didn't open it.
And it reveals this thing called library properties. And this is probably the most important thing to know about in 10.1.2 related to media management.
Right, is that you're setting up your library. You're telling Final Cut Pro where your media is going to go.
Where you're copying it.
Where you're copying it.
When you import.
Exactly.
Okay.
So here under library properties, the first thing I want to point out is where the media is physically stored on your hard drive.
Here where the library is.
Library, sorry. Okay. In this case, it's stored on the Macintosh hard drive. You saw me save it there.
So your root drive, because you never renamed your root drive. Macintosh HD.
No, it's Macintosh HD, right.
Right.
So here, the next section, storage locations. That is like it sounds. It's your storage locations for your media. And storage locations is actually broken down into three subsections. You have media, cache, and backups.
Right.
So let's go through each in turn.
Okay.
Media would be, well, like it sounds, media that you import. Video clips off your camera or CF card, your hard drive. It could be photos, sound files, animation files, anything related to the project you're going to be building.
So anything you import will be in this, is represented under the media section.
That's right.
Okay.
Then the next section, cache, that essentially is your render files and your analysis files. So when you generate an effect at the high quality, that gets stored as a render file. If you're analyzing, let's say a camera, something with camera shake in it.
Or stabilization, optical flow.
Optical flow, that gets stored. That's essentially what's called the cache.
Okay.
And also thumbnails, all those little thumbnails that get drawn in the waveforms, that's part of the cache as well.
Got it.
Right? So look what's happening here. By default, Final Cut Pro is putting that in the library. More on that in a moment. Last thing here, backups. Those are what they sound like. They're backups of your library, because it's possible that you can accidentally delete a library or it can become corrupted or what have you. You can back up from this backup.
You can restore from the backups because it's backing up automatically for you to that location.
Right. Okay. And by default, Final Cut Pro puts the backups folder in the user's movies folder.
Right.
Right. So let's talk about this section here, media and cache, because that's essentially, you know, the building blocks. That's where it's taking up all the drive space. Where's your media going? When you connect a camera or a CF card, where's the media going?
When you copy it, where's it going to be copied
to?
Exactly. Uh-huh.
And what this is telling us is that it's going to go in the library. It's going to be copied directly into the library bundle. What Apple calls a managed library.
And that's the default setting. And if you're an individual editor, that's probably what you want to do.
Well, yeah, because, well, you can take that library and just move it around at will, move it to different computers, drives, all the media goes with it.
It's completely self-contained.
In fact, we said earlier, it's like a suitcase. Yeah. So you can literally move it around. You don't have to worry about offline clips. It's probably the simplest setup is this a managed library. In fact, this is exactly the way iMovie is. You don't have any other choice. It's a managed library. So there are instances where you don't want your media in the library. For example, let's say you and I are on a network and we want to share the media. Yeah. Well, if all the media is in the library, how are you going to access it?
In that case, you'd want it in some external location where multiple editors would have access
right.
to it.
So let's look at quickly how to set that up. We're not going to do it because Mark's going to go through that much later in some of the scenarios lessons, but I at least want to introduce you to the concept now.
Great.
Okay, so here we are. In the storage locations, you have this new button called Modify Settings. If you click this button, a window will come up, and there's your three subsections.
Exact same three that we see there, media, cache, and backups.
That's right. Mm-hmm. And it's all related to this library that's selected, California Underwater. Right? So we already defined what these are, and by default, it's set for in library, a managed library.
Got it.
But you can override that with this pop-up, and you simply set choose, and then I'm going to put this media on an external drive. Here one I've called Ripple Media. And I'm going to create a new folder to put it in. I'm going to put underwater media. And I'm going to click create. So I have this folder, and I'm going to click choose. Now notice the media is now targeted for this external folder. I'm going to click OK. You can do the same thing for cache, which we're not going to do right now. I just want to show you the process of how you retarget. Okay. So I'm going to click OK. And the first thing you'll notice is that in the media section, the folder is now targeted for your media, not the library.
So now if you import media, it won't be copied into the library, it will be copied to that folder.
Correct.
And a cool thing is, by the way, when you're importing media, if you choose to transcode the media because you want to make optimized media or proxy media, that transcoded media will also be placed in that external folder, and that's a new feature.
It's a brand new feature. People have been asking for that. I don't want all of my optimized and proxy media inside the library, and previous to this version, that's the only place it existed.
Yeah, so this is a huge deal for people who are doing collaborative workflows.
Huge, huge. Okay, so just wanted to walk you through that. We're gonna go into much more detail later, but what I wanna do is set this back to in library for now. So I'm gonna go back to the Modify Settings button. I'm gonna set this back to in library, and I'm gonna go ahead and click OK. Notice the icon changes, and we're back to a managed library. All right, so let's bring in some media. Now, when I created the library, an event was automatically created for me, and it essentially named it with the date.
The date.
Okay, and somewhat useful, but I typically like to rename these.
I always rename them.
Yeah, why not? So I'm gonna call this Kelp Forest, because this event is
gonna
be related to Kelp Forest. Okay. So I'm gonna hit return, okay, and now I'm gonna start importing media directly into that event. It's interesting that you don't really import media into a library, you import it into an event that's in a library.
Yes.
Right. So I'm gonna go ahead and click import media, and I'm going to navigate to my external drive, and here I have a folder of media. I'm not gonna bring in a bunch of it, I'll just select a couple of clips here, and I'm gonna click import selected. All right. And we get the import dialog. Now, this has changed quite a bit from the previous version. Previously, you have the option to select an external library right here in this window.
Yes. But we've already done that.
We did that in the library properties inspector. Yeah. So it assumes that you want to copy it to the library. In fact, that's your only choice.
So that's really the main change in this window, is now you don't have the option here because you've already made that decision. So instead of needing to decide every time you import, wait a minute, am I going to go in the library external? It's like, no, you don't need to deal with that. You've set it up once. It's like, set it and forget it. Set it when you create the library.
Set it and forget it.
And now it's just copy the library. There's no option to copy to an external location.
Right. So when I click import, those two files that I have selected in the import window, they will be copied into the library. Okay. There's one other option we're going to look at in a minute, but I want to introduce them now. It's called Leave Files in Place. Essentially what that is, someone hands you a drive with media on it. You don't want to copy it into the library. You just want to reference the library. In other words, they hand you a drive, a terabyte, 2 terabytes of stuff. You don't want to copy that in. You just want to reference it where it is. You want to leave it in place.
All right, so wait a minute. Because you just got through telling me we set up the library either to be inside or outside. It's very simple, A or B, inside or outside. And we set the library up as inside, as managed. So like I'm done, but now I also still have the option not to copy the files anywhere, but to leave files right where they are.
That's right.
And leave them outside the library. And so even with a managed library, you can have files that are outside the library.
Yeah, Even with a managed library, you can still reference external files. And you said it, the key was this. The key is copy. We're not copying anything. When you hook up a camera or hard drive, you're copying media into the library. In this sense, we're not copying, we're just simply referencing it.
And you want that flexibility. You want to be able to, in any instance, whether you have a managed library or external media, you want the option to be able to leave media where it is. Like you say, if somebody hands you a drive full of media, and you don't want to have to copy it all. You just want to point to it.
Right.
Okay.
So I'm going to go ahead and go back to copy the library, and we'll just leave everything the way it is. Those of you who are already familiar with Final Cut Pro, everything up here is related to where it's going to go inside Final Cut. Everything below this line is where it's going to go relative to where it's stored on your hard drive.
Got it.
So I'm just going to click Import. All right. Instantly, those clips come in. If I open up the background task manager, you can see, background task window, you can see that the clips are being copied into the library.
Great.
So what I want to do is reinforce this idea of the media being copied into the library, a managed library. And the quickest way to reinforce that or show you is to right-click on the library itself and choose Reveal in Finder. And that will, of course, take us to the library location, in this case, in the Movies folder. And if you right-click on the library itself, you can choose Show Package Contents, which will reveal the contents of that package.
Okay, because it is a package. That library is actually a bundle. And technically, you can't open it. You can't double-click it to open it. That will just launch Final Cut. But you are going inside the bundle here to take a look.
Right, and it's worth pointing out that normally, you don't ever need to go into the bundle. Right. We're just going in there to show you what's actually happening under the hood.
We're never going to change anything in here.
That's right. In fact, if you start going into changing stuff in the bundle, you're going to have some problems.
Don't go there.
So here, you'll notice there's a folder called Kelp Forest. It's a folder that mirrors the event name in
the
library.
So clearly, this event really is basically a folder.
It's basically a folder, okay. Exactly. But if I open the original media folder by clicking on it, you'll see those are the two clips that were copied into it.
And those are real clips right there.
They're
not any references. So copy those clips directly into the library.
Exactly.
Perfect. Got it.
All right. So let's look at one more example, Mark. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go back to Final Cut Pro, and I'm going to select the event, and I'm going to open the import window one more time. And I'm going to just select a couple of other clips here. I'm just going to go ahead and select these ones down here at the bottom. Click Import Selected. And this time, we're going to choose Leave Files in Place.
Okay.
Okay. In this case, we're not going to be copying them. We're just going to be referencing them. I'm going to click Import. And they come right in. They're just like that. Okay. So
immediately, they're available. There was no copying going on. There's a little bit of activity going on that background task window, but I believe that's just generating the waveforms for those clips.
Yes. You can open this up, and that's all it's doing is generating background waveforms and thumbnails and what have you. But point is, let's go back out and look at the library again, see what happened. If I right-click and choose Reveal in Finder, go back and open up the Finder bundle again, Show Package, and go into Kelp Forest, into Original Media, you'll notice something here. You'll notice that I have two real clips, what I call real clips.
The first two you imported.
Right. And these two clips are what they call SIM clips, or short for symbolic clips.
Symbolic links to the original media.
To the original media, because again, we didn't copy into the library.
Yeah. In fact, it says right there, the kind is an alias. It's an alias, a SIM link, a reference file.
Right. Oh. And in fact, if
and it's
you
very, right, very small.
It's very, very small. In fact, if you right-click on it and choose Show Original, it'll actually behave exactly like an alias. It'll bring you to where the original media is, in this case, on my external drive.
Got it. Okay, so you have the option. Whether you choose a managed library or external library, you always have this option to do leave in place.
Always have the option to leave in place. Back in Final Cut Pro, I wanted to show you one other thing. If I select the library and look at the library properties, you'll notice something down here called media locations. Final Cut Pro is aware that media exists on two separate drives and will actually visually show you this right here. There's Macintosh HD, there's Ripple Media. So it's telling me I have media two different drives.
I love the entire library properties window because it tells you up top where the library itself lives. Mm-hmm. Then it tells you where all your media and cache files are. Mm-hmm. And then it tells you what drives contain your actual media. So basically, it's a full information pane on where everything is located.
Where everything is located.
Yeah, it's terrific.
Now, at some point, we might want to take all the media and bundle it all up, you know, consolidate it to one drive, which we're not going to do now. But it's really helpful visually to see what's going on.
Exactly. It's beautiful.
So what we want to do now is essentially summarize. We've covered a lot of material, and it sometimes helps visually to see what's actually happening. And we're visual guys, so we like to make graphics. So here, let's just do a quick review. Libraries are production units. So they're like a little suitcase. And within them, they contain events, and events contain projects and media, which you can see represented there in the little white rectangle, right? Now, the media for these events can exist in one of two locations. It can reside inside the library, called a managed library, or it can reside outside the library, called external media. So you can see here, you can have your media sitting on a Pegasus RAID or something else that the library is referencing using symlinks.
So whenever you copy media into Final Cut Pro, when you import, you can choose to copy it into the library or copy it to an external location.
Now, in terms of importing media, these graphics will help you see that you're either importing directly into the library, as in this this first graphic on the far left. And so when you hook up a camera, connect a camera to your computer or import from a camera archive, that media is copied directly into the library, a managed volume. In the graphic in the center, if you have your library set up to external media, when you copy it, it'll get copied to an external folder, as you see here, and references called symlinks are created to that external folder, right? And then the last graphic, the far right, leave files in place, Final Cut Pro is simply creating refs or symlinks to the media files that already exist on the drive.
And the big difference in 10.1.2 is whether you import into the library or into a folder is set in that library properties window now, not every time you import. You set it once, set it and forget it pretty much. But then when you import, you always have this additional option to leave the files where they are.
Always have the additional option.
Okay. Fantastic.
So in the next lesson, we're going to look at specific media management guidelines that define how media management takes place in Final Cut Pro 10. And we'll also look at specific operations such as consolidate, using the modify button to change from managed to external, and moving and copying. It's a crucial lesson with regard to how you would manage your media.
Once you understand the basic guidelines and the basic commands, there's really nothing you can't do in terms of managing media in Final Cut.
Excellent. So that's what we'll do next.